Live from the 107th floor of the Cat Country 107.3 studios, just outside beautiful Atlantic City, New Jersey. It's the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge. It's your chance to fire up your brain and show South Jersey exactly who you are. Now, here are your hosts, Joe and Jahna.
Jahna, who's our contestant?
Hank from California.
Wait, not just any Hank. Actor Hank Azaria, who's famous for The Simpsons and many other things. Hank, welcome to the show.
Hi, Hank.
Thank you. Thank you for having me on. Appreciate it.
We're so excited to have you on the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge. Now, we have a question for you, a quiz question.
Do you mind if I call you Joe and Jahna?
It's easier, isn't it? I know.
We do it all the time. Both
Joe.
Of us. Yeah.
All right, no problem. Good. I'm sorry. Go ahead. What do you got?
I love that he asked that because I do that to you so much.
Before we get to the actual quiz question, an actual honest question, kind of a test question. Of all the roles that you've done, acting, movie, TV, behind the scenes, voice, who's the your favorite character you've ever played?
Ooh.
My favorite of all time is Moe the bartender on The Simpsons. Just because I used to actually bartend, so I kind of feel like if I didn't become Moe the bartender, I would have remained Hank the bartender.
That's good.
But the one that people talk to me about the most is Agador Spartacus from The Birdcage. He's the one that people come up to me the most about.
That's good.
It's an imitation of my grandmother. There's a fun fact for you.
That's awesome.
I must talk like this.
All right. Let's get to the actual quiz question. Are you ready, Hank Azaria?
I guess. All right, let's go, Joe.
Here's the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge question. In 20 seconds, Hank, give us the voices of four of your favorite Simpson characters, all expressing their love and adoration for Jahna.
Ooh.
Go.
Well, you heard from Mo. He loves girls with soft J's names there. Comic book guy, he would say best name ever. Professor Frank, of course, with all of the sound of the J's and J's. And let's go with Cletus. Cletus can't pronounce it. Jahna. I'm going to call you Jahna.
That works.
That works. Nailed it.
Hank Azaria, you're a winner of the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge.
Lucky I came along because anybody else probably wouldn't have done too well at that.
That's right.
Probably not. Right?
Jahna, tell Hank what he's won.
Absolutely nothing but my heart forever and ever, that's for sure.
Well, that's a lot. That's seriously a lot.
I'm actually going to cash it in.
This has been the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge from Cat Country 107.3.
Cat Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Good morning. Welcome to a Tuesday morning. It is the 15th day of October. It's I Love Lucy Day. The TV show I Love Lucy.
I used to love watching that show back in the day
on
Nick
and
Night.
Lucy. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, she was so
rest
good.
Health day.
Yes,
I'll be doing checkups at the back of my car later today.
Oh geez.
It's Grouch Day and Red Wine Day. Good morning. We're Joe and Jahna here at the Know this morning. But first, a traffic note. Some emergency road work being done this morning in Egg Harbor Township on the Black Horse Pike approaching Fire Road eastbound. Traffic is down to one lane. Well, four people were arrested for an armed robbery and assault that took place in Mays Landing last week. Two of the suspects were picked up by the FBI in Philadelphia. The other two arrested in Oklahoma City.
Vineland's police chief has reportedly been suspended following an arrest on simple assault charges. Not many details are available about just what happened.
State officials say hunters killed more than 20 bear on the first day of the six-day bear hunt in northern New Jersey. The state says the hunt helps manage the size of the bear population here in New Jersey. Stats show the number of bear damage and nuisance incidents is up 17% this year compared to the same time frame last year.
And your South Jersey weather for today, it's partly sunny and breezy with a high of 60.
Storm season is here. Atlantic City Electric knows a little prep makes a big difference. See how you can stay connected during storms and prepare to weather any weather at atlanticcityelectric.com/stormprep. Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for Jahna's Fangirl Update.
And the big news out of Nashville yesterday, it was all about how Brantley Gilbert had to run off stage for an hour in Mississippi to help his wife Amber deliver their son right on his tour bus, like parked right outside. Now he's revealing why Amber even had to deliver from the bus in the first place. Long story short, they didn't think their son Abram was going to come so soon. They thought they had at least a week left. Even Amber's midwife was surprised. Brantley Gilbert's talking about the entire experience. Check it out right now at catcountry1073.com. If you've been waiting for an opening date for Luke Combs' spot in Nashville, well, congratulations. Today's that day. Category 10 is his bar's official name. It's all set to open its doors on Saturday, November 2nd. So the venue is going to feature some more traditional attractions. It's got a stocked kitchen, two specialty cocktail recipes. Both of those are nods to Luke Combs' songs. One is the beautiful Crazy Sangria, and the other is called Ain't No Love. It features vodka, watermelon puree, lemon, sour, and spicy agave. Sign me up for that. All the details about Luke Combs' new Nashville hotspot are up for you right now on the Cat Country 107.3 app. That's Jahna's Fangirl Update on Cat Country
107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna, coming up at 7:20. A couple things. First of all, we're going to give away $30,000. We'll announce the winner of our $30,000 Cash Cow Contest. Hopefully it'll be yours. Also, about that time, we'll be zeroing in our Joe and Jahna question of the day for today. Here's the question. $1 million or your pet? Which one are you going to choose?
I can't even believe you would even, like, pose that question to us.
You can get another.
I'm so upset.
You can get another pet for $99 and have almost $1 million for yourself after that.
No, that's not funny.
The best answer to the question thus far has been from Gwen.
I'm scared to ask.
What happens to the pet?
Yeah, right?
If I give up the Mary Underwood, American Girl. Jahna, have things changed in America in the last 100 years?
I would say so, yeah.
100 years ago, listen to what was happening.
Okay.
The average life expectancy in the U.S. was about 58 years.
I was going to say 47.
Less than half of U.S. homes had indoor plumbing.
That's nuts.
A three-minute coast-to-coast telephone call
cost
$20.
Gee.
And that was in that money, not today's
right.
money.
Right.
Maximum speed limit in most cities was 20 miles per hour. There weren't a lot of cars.
Oh, my gosh. Now, if you go 25 miles an hour, you might get run over.
Most births in the U.S. took place at home.
Yeah.
Average income 100 years ago, between $2,200 and $3,400 a year.
Nuts.
And women had just gained the right to vote with the 19th Amendment. Cat Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for your Cat Country Joke of the Morning. Happens every weekday morning at this time from Abseek, and Gary has sent us today's joke.
Gary, thank you.
Why is it when I donate a kidney, I'm a hero? But when I donate six kidneys, the police have all these questions.
I mean, little different. Little different.
And when I bring in my blood donations in buckets.
Wow.
It's Cat Country 107. Mornings with Joe and Jahna, Cat Country 107.3. Good morning. We've got some big stuff coming up just after 7:15. Our Joe and Jahna question of the day today.
This is awful.
$1 million or your pet? You can choose one. We're not going to tell you what happens to your pet if you choose the $1 million.
That's awful. That's not even, I feel like that's a loaded question.
So
you're setting us up. I already know my answer.
Your dog will be taken away. You'll never see it again. How's that?
Absolutely.
You're going to take the pet.
Diabolical.
You're going to take the pet or the $1 million.
I'm afraid to answer this.
All right. We're going to talk about it at 7:15. You can answer us 609-383-1073 or hit the message us button on the Cat Country 107.3 app. And at about 7:20, we'll announce our big winner of Cash Cow, $30,000. That's coming up, Cat Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for your Cat Country Dumb Story of the Morning.
All right, let's go.
Dress for the job you want, not for the job you have. A burglar in England easily caught because he was wearing a high-visibility fluorescent bib. Well, this is for my job later.
Yeah.
It's Cat Country 107.3.
Shouldn't you be wearing, like, all black if you're going to...
Good morning, we're Joe and Jahna here at the Know this morning. But first, a traffic note, some emergency road work being done this morning in Egg Harbor Township on the Black Horse Pike approaching Fire Road eastbound. Traffic is down to one lane. Well, four people were arrested for an armed robbery and assault that took place in Mays Landing last week. Two of the suspects were picked up by the FBI in Philadelphia. The other two arrested in Oklahoma City.
Vineland's police chief has reportedly been suspended following an arrest on simple assault charges. Not many details are available about just what happened.
State officials say hunters killed more than 20 bear on the first day of the six-day bear hunt in northern New Jersey. The state says the hunt helps manage the size of the bear population here in Jersey. Stats show the number of bear damage and nuisance incidents is up 17% this year compared to the same time frame last year.
And your South Jersey weather for today, it's partly sunny and breezy with a high of 60.
Storm season is here. Atlantic City Electric knows a little prep makes a big difference. See how you can stay connected during storms and prepare to weather any weather at atlanticcityelectric.com/stormprep. Three mornings with Joe and Jahna. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Here we go. Cat Country morning birthday shout-outs start right now.
We've got a shout-out, a famous birthday today. It's Kimberly Schlappman. You know her from Little Big Town. She's 55 today.
Happy birthday, Courtney Geisens of Dennisville. Courtney is 40. Vinny Agnello is 51 today. Brian Passarella of Millville celebrates today. It's Alicia Woodrow's birthday. She's from Cape May Courthouse. Alicia is 43. Walter Bell Sr. of Rio Grande celebrates today. It's Nancy Ridgeway's birthday. She's from Atlantic City. Happy birthday, Nancy.
Nancy, happy birthday.
Happy birthday to Nora Jones from Beasley's Point. Nora Jones is 62.
Nice.
We miss you. Happy one to you as well. The recipient of our Cat Country Big Birthday shout out today, Alicia Woodrow of Cape May Courthouse. She's 43. Dasha in Austin. Good morning. 7:15 coming up in 5 or 6 minutes. We're going to announce the winner of $30,000 in cash with Cash Cow. That's on the way. But in the meantime, it's the Joe and Jahna question of the day today. $1 million or your dog or your pet? Which would you choose? $1 million or your pet? 609-383-1073. Hit the message us button on the Cat Country 107.3 app. What do you think? $1 million or your pet? Teresa says, that's like asking me to give up a family member. My four cats, two dogs, and a birds are my family. Lucinda says she's choosing her pets rather than $1 million. By the way, if you choose $1 million, we're going to have your pet shipped off to a nice family in Seattle. That's better than what we were talking about earlier. So there you go. If you pick the money, your pets will be shipped off to a nice family in Seattle to be cared for. You'll never be able to talk to them again. Amy says, my dog is 14, blind, deaf, and on borrowed time. He's had a great life. Pass me the dough. Jack says, Amy, is your pup's name Lucky? $1 million or your pet? Laverne says, my cat. Jeff says, my dogs. But his wife Rebecca says, if Jeff keeps the dogs, can I keep the money? Gwen says, are we talking trading the existing pet? And what happens to the pet? Again, it'll go to a nice family in Seattle if you pick the money instead. Shelby says she picks her pets. Jennifer says her pets. Lindsay says, you're telling me that my pet isn't worth more than $1 million? Colleen wants her dogs. Ashley says, I'll keep my farm. Laura says, if I had $1 million, I'd give it away to bring back my puppy dog Ace from heaven. Well, that's not the deal. Your pets are $1 million. 609-383-1073 or hit the message us button on the Cat Country 107.3 mornings with Joe and Jahna. She wasn't easy to get a hold of, but Emily is standing by on the phone. Emily, do you use our Cat Country 107.3 app?
I do. I was using it for doing the 30,000 mm-hmm. thing.
Do you have any kids?
I have a 7-year-old, and then I also have a 4-year-old.
Well, we know you've been trying to win the cash with Cash Cow. For your kids, Emily, if you won, what would you do with all the money, $30,000?
We want to go to the new park that they're building at Universal.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. Well, we're not going to drag this out anymore. Emily, you're our big winner.
You
won $30,000.
I was wondering why I got a phone call. Yeah. I didn't answer. I don't even know what to say.
You're welcome. Congratulations, Emily. She wins $30,000. Take away your bet.
Okay, guys. I want $2 million. I got two goldfish you can play.
Again, $1 million or your pet.
Okay. $1 million, two goldfish.
All right. My baby born a Birkin.
He's been telling me all night long. Gasoline and groceries. The list goes on and on. It's 9 to 5 ain't working. Why the hell do I work so hard? I can't worry about my problems. I can't take them when I'm gone. One, here comes the 2 to the 3 to the 4. Tell them bring another round, we need plenty more. Two stepping on the table, she don't need a dance floor. Oh my, good lord. Someone pour me up a double shot of whiskey. They know me and Jay Daniels got a history. There's a party downtown near 5th Street. Everybody at the bar getting tipsy. Everybody at the bar getting tipsy. Everybody at the bar getting tipsy. I've been boozy since I left. I ain't changing for a check. Tell my mind I ain't forget. I'm drunk at 10 a.m. We gon' do this shit again. Tell your girl to bring a friend. Oh, Lord. One, here comes the 2 to the 3 to the 4. Tell them bring another round. We need 30 more. Two-stepping on the table. She don't need a dance floor. Oh, my. Good Lord. Someone pour me up a double shot of whiskey. They know me and Jay Daniels got a history. There's a party downtown near 5th Street. Everybody at the comes the 2 to the 3 to the 4. When it's last call and they kick us out the door. It's getting kinda late, but the ladies want some more. Oh my, good Lord. Tell them drink some. Someone pour me up a double shot of whiskey. They know me and Jay Daniels got a history. There's a party downtown near 5th Street.
This is the Cat Country Morning Show with Joe and Jahna. Cat Country 107.3, a Town Square media station serving South Jersey and available on the Cat Country 107.3 app.
This is the Town Square, New Jersey Info and Weather Network.
Hey, it's Chris Coleman. Volunteers are needed for Clean Ocean Action's Fall Beach Sweeps. That's coming up this Saturday at beaches across Atlantic and Cape May counties. It starts at 9 Saturday morning, runs until about 12:30 or so. If you want to participate, you need to register in advance, and you can do so right now on or at the goal of the beach sweeps, obviously to reduce and eliminate sources of litter across the beautiful beaches here in South.
From the Town Square, New Jersey Info and Weather Network, I'm Chief Meteorologist Dan Zarrow. The good news, today will not be quite as windy and blustery as yesterday afternoon. Still breezy, though, and temperatures still running about 10 degrees below normal for this time of year. Look for a mix of clouds and sun today, high temperature only 59. Mainly clear and chilly tonight, low of 40. Another breezy, cool day coming up tomorrow, partly sunny and dry, high 58, climbing to 61 Thursday. Get weather 24/7 wherever you are. Download our free mobile app today.
Atlanticare Cancer.
It's Jess on the job with you. By far, this might be one of the craziest things that has ever happened at a show. I'll tell you all about it at 11:20. You're not going to believe it. On Cat Country 107.
Ocean City is listening to Joe and Jahna. Cat Country 107.3.
With an arrow, a gravel lot chock full of toolbox trucks, making their happy hour way home. When guys like me lose girls like you, that's where we run to. They got whiskey river on the jukebox, a honky tonk sawdust dance floor, a neon 5 o'clock road clock, and plenty damn many when you want more. This road car fool on an old bar stool drinking beer almost
time numbers on the stall door. A picture of you on the dartboard. Them cinder block walls ain't ever been clean. Still as dirty as you done me.
Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Cat Country Morning Trivia is up next, brought to you by South Jersey Gas. Our phone number is 609-383-1073. Or hit the call us button on the Cat Country 107.3 app. Today's prize, a good one. Four tickets to Always Fun Scoville Tire in the Junkyard Hayride.
Oh, yeah.
That's at Fleming Junkyard on Zion Road in Egg Harbor Township. It happens every Saturday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday nights in October. So you got two more big weekends coming up, I think.
Yeah, you got plenty of time.
Weather's been perfect for a hayride, so this will be great. Four tickets to Scoville's Tear in the Junkyard. Here's the question. One out of five grandparents don't like this about their grandchildren. One in five grandparents don't like this about their grandchildren.
Grandparents aren't supposed to not like it. Well, like everything.
One in five say, I don't like this about my grandchild.
I'm so confused.
609-383. Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Trivia's on the air at stake. Four tickets to Scoville's Tear in the Junkyard in Egg Harbor Township every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Fleming's Junkyard, Zion Road, and EHT. Always a fun time. Here's the question. One out of five grandparents don't like this about their grandchild. What don't they like?
Is it the way that they talk back?
No.
No?
Although...
Okay. I mean, kids are sassy.
I remember when I was a kid.
Yeah.
50 years ago, more. I remember my grandmother told me something and I gave her the finger.
Did she discipline you?
No.
Oh.
That was like... the worst sin of my life right there. I still regret it today.
I never did that to my grandma.
I just want to go home and cry right now.
But.
I feel bad. I still feel bad.
I think I would too.
There was no reason I should have done that at 6 years old.
My cousin Charlie and I, we used to see who could get our grandma to cuss first.
That's nice.
That was the game that we played when we were really young.
I'll see you in hell as well.
No. All right. I love her so much. She's gone now.
One in five grandparents don't like this about their grandchild. What don't they like?
Besides everything.
Hi, Cat Country.
Tattoos?
No, that's not it. Thank you. That's a good one.
That is a good one.
Hi, Cat Country. What's your answer?
Could it be their language? Their slang?
No, that's not it. Thank you. Grandparents, one in five grandparents don't like this about their grandchild. Hi, Cat Country.
Yes, hi. Is it that they live too far away?
No, that's not it. Thank you.
Oh, I love that answer.
Hi, Cat Country. What's your answer?
Is it their hairstyle?
No, that's not it. Thank you. What's this kid doing?
Mine's not that.
Hi, Cat Country. What's your answer?
I don't think.
Their name.
Absolutely right. You're our winner.
All right.
Wow.
Don't like the kid's wacky name. What's your name?
No. Mark. Very easy name.
There you go, Mark. We all love your name.
Mark with a...
Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. We'd love to send you to Florida, Jacksonville to be specific, to see Jelly Roll in concert. Airfare, hotel, $500 cash. And, of course, two tickets to Jelly Roll all included. We got five chances to win today. Your first chance to win the Jelly Roll tickets coming up at 8:20 this morning here at Cat Country 107.3. In the meantime, congratulations again to Emily Barnish, the winner of $30,000 in cash cow. Emily, very thankful for her victory.
I want to thank you guys so much. I don't even have words at all. It's like, not, I would have never thought that something like this would ever happen to me. Thank you.
Good morning. We're things you need to know this morning. But first, a traffic note. Some emergency road work being done this morning in Egg Harbor Township on the Black Horse Pike approaching Fire Road eastbound. Traffic is down to one lane. Well, four people were arrested for an armed robbery and assault that took place in Mays Landing last week. Two of the suspects were picked up by the FBI in Philadelphia. The other two arrested in Oklahoma City.
Vineland's police chief has reportedly been suspended following an arrest on simple assault charges. Not many details are available about just what happened.
State officials say hunters killed more than 20 bear on the first day of the six-day bear hunt in northern New Jersey. The state says the hunt helps manage the size of the bear population here in Jersey. Stats show the number of bear damage and nuisance incidents is up 17% this year compared to the same time frame last year.
And your South Jersey weather for today, it's partly sunny and breezy with a high of 60.
Storm season is here. Atlantic City Electric knows a little prep makes a big difference. See how you can stay connected during storms and prepare to weather any weather at atlanticcityelectric.com/stormprep. Cat Country 107.3, mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for my favorite tweets from the last 24 hours.
We're ready.
There are five of them. Number one, what kind of neighborhood do I live in? Put it this way, the kids are on leashes and the poodles are in strollers.
That sounds about right.
Longport.
And you have bougie. Yeah, you definitely are like rich, kind of.
Number two, you're not bloated. That's just your body now. Have a nice day.
Yeah.
Number three.
It's coming.
Sometimes I think I'm reasonably intelligent, and sometimes I click the remote car door lock a second or third time for just extra lockiness.
Just to make sure, yeah.
Number four, if you ever see me running, call the police. I'm not doing it voluntarily.
Yep.
We're Joe and Jahna. These are my favorite tweets. Last one, number five. Hearing those four little words always make my day. Your great mornings with Joe and Jahna. We've got a fabulous trip we'd like to send you on to see Jelly Roll in Jacksonville, Florida.
The one you've been waiting for. This one's big. Sunny Florida, a Jelly Roll concert. You're going to have the time of your life.
And as many peanut butter and jelly sandwiches you can eat at the concert as you can.
And you can fit in your nooks and crannies sneak them in there.
In your nooks and crannies. Who wouldn't want to have a
nook and cranny PB&J?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
So you need to listen five times today to get the Jelly Roll code. When you get a code, go to the Cat Country 107.3 app. Click on the Jelly Roll tickets button, and you could be the big winner. Listen at 8:20 and 10:20 in the morning, 1:20 and 4:20 in the afternoon, and about 7:20 on Taste of Country Nights with Evan for the fifth and final code.
Okay.
Here it is, your first code of the day.
Yeah.
225.
Nice. 225. You're going to open up the Cat Country 107.3 app. The button that you need to hit says Jelly Roll Tickets. 225. Jess will be back at 10:20 this morning with your next chance.
Cat Country 107.3. Mornings with Joe and Jahna. If you're just joining us, you missed the big news with our friend Emily. Emily, do you use our Cat Country 107.3 app?
I do. I was using it for doing the 30,000 thing.
Do you have any kids?
I have a 7-year-old, and then I also have a 4-year-old.
Well, we know you've been trying to win the cash with Cash Cow. For your kids, Emily, if you won, what would you do with all the money, $30,000?
We want to go to the new park that they're building at Universal.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. Well, we're not going to drag this out anymore. Emily, you're our big winner.
What?
You won $30,000.
I was wondering why I got a phone call. I didn't answer. I don't even...